Good morning, children. Have a nice day. I am from Mahatma Gandhi Vidyalaya. I am Mrs. Nandini, your social teacher. I am going to say a thought before going to the lesson. Thought: it is very easy to defeat someone, but it is very hard to win someone. You can easily defeat one person but not win. It is difficult to win. The thought again I repeat: it is very easy to defeat someone, but it is very hard to win someone. Today I am going to take the lesson from political science. The lesson name is On Equality. This lesson is about equality and inequalities in India. What is equality? Equality means all are equal before the law. All are equal before the law. All are equal. So about that we are going to see in the lesson. So now in this picture you are seeing a ballot box. Here during the election day, everybody can cast their vote. This voting box is very very important. One vote for one person is allowed in India. So each and every vote have an importance in India. Now I am going to tell you about the universal adult franchise. It means that all adult citizens, those who are 18 and above age, have the right to vote irrespective of their social or economic backgrounds. It means all the adult citizens. Citizen means the people of India, Indian citizen. So who are all having the age 18 and above, they have the right to vote irrespective of their social or economic backgrounds. Means there is no bias based on the social and economic background. Social background means there is no disparity, whether Hindu or Muslim or Christian or high class or low class, anybody can put the vote. Similarly, economic background means there is no differences like rich or poor. Again, I repeat, universal adult franchise means all adult citizens, those who are 18 and above the age, have the right to vote irrespective of their social or economic background. So those who have 18 and above age, they must be the Indian citizen. They can have the right to vote. There is no disparity based on social or economic backgrounds. Now this lesson starts with an election day. On election day, Kanta Devi, a domestic worker, standing in a line to cast her vote. So I am now going to tell the story of Kanta Devi. Kanta is excited to vote and happy that she is equal to all of the others because each of them has one vote. And she is very very happy to see that her employer also standing in the same line. So she feels that she is equal with the employer. I said Kanta Devi is a domestic worker. Domestic worker means a worker who helps to wash the cloth and cook food and clean the vessels and all in your house with your mother. So in the house, she will help to your mother in all the works. So Kanta Devi is also working in a house as a domestic worker. And she is standing in a line to cast the vote. At the same time, her employer also that. So she feels very very happy that both are in the same line, both are equal. She lives in a slum and has a drain behind her house. Her daughter is sick, but she cannot take the day off from work because she needs to borrow money from her employers to take her child to the doctor. Her job as a domestic worker tires her out, and finally she ends her day by taking the child to the doctor. And here the picture shows that Kanta is working as a domestic worker and her employer is there, and full day she works, and then she gets the money, she borrows the money from the employer for taking her child to the doctor. And again, when she takes the child to the doctor, she takes the child to the government hospital. So she ends her day in standing in a long line in the hospital. It means she is waiting for the doctor, for her turn. So, in the government hospital, she is standing in a long line. This line in front of the government hospital is unlike the one in the morning, because most of the people standing in it are poor. In the morning, for the election to cast her vote, she is standing in a line. There, rich, poor, various religious people, everybody standing there without any disparity. But here in the government hospital, poor people only standing in the line, because rich people will not come here, they will go for private hospital. So Kanta is imagining, just thinking, when her employer's child gets sick, does she come here? No, she go to a private hospital. She will not wait in this long queue. She get the appointment from the private doctor and goes there. The private doctor cost is high comparing with the government. So the Kanta thinks that there is no equality between her and the employer. By comparing this, Kanta thinks that, is it equality? No, we have inequality. Like that Kanta thinks. Kanta is one of many people who live in democratic India and who have the right to vote, but whose daily living and working conditions are far from equal. Apart from being poor, people in India experience inequality in different ways. Inequalities in India, based on the religion, based on the caste, based on the economy, based on the gender. Based on the religion, India is having many religions: Hindu, Muslim, Christian, Jainism, Buddhism, like that. And similarly, caste based, higher caste, lower caste, like that, caste based. And economy, rich, poor, we have seen in the Kanta's case. Kanta is a poor domestic worker. And gender, male, female, gender bias, male, female. So like that, there are various inequalities in India. And the people are struggling to overcome all these inequalities. Now, let us go to the next one, caste inequality. Already we are seeing the inequality based on the economy. Now we are going to see the inequality based on the caste one. Even in the caste, in India we have higher caste and lower caste. Certain people are said that they are lower classes and certain people are said that they are higher classes. There is a term, Dalit. Dalit is a term that is representing the lower class used to address themselves. Dalit means broken. Om Prakash Valmiki is a famous Dalit writer. He written a book, Jutan. It's his autobiography. It says that, in his book he says that, I had to sit away from others in the class and that too on the floor. The mat ran out before reaching the spot I sat on. Sometime I would have to sit way behind everybody, right near the door. So he was separated from other children. He is not sitting with others. Sometime they would beat me without any reason. Sometime they will beat him without any reason. And he had written, the school, the headmaster asked Om Prakash to sweep the school and playground. He writes, in the 6th standard, when he was in 6th standard, headmaster asked him to sweep the school and the playground. And Om Prakash is, at that time Om Prakash was a small boy and he is not able to do that. The playground is so big. But still, because of his headmaster, he has done it. He had written, my face was covered with dust. Dust had gone inside my mouth. The other children in my class were studying and I was sweeping. Headmaster was sitting in his room and watching me. I was not even allowed to get a drink of water. I swept the whole day. From the doors and windows of the school rooms, the eyes of the teachers and the boys saw this spectacle. Om Prakash was made to sweep the school and playground for the next couple of days. And this only came to an end when his father, who happened to be passing by, saw his son sweeping. His father was shocked to see this condition. He confronted the teachers and then walking away from the school holding Om Prakash's hand, he said loudly for all of them to hear, "You are a teacher, so I am leaving now. But remember this much, master. He will study right here in this school. And not just him, but there will be more coming after him. So more will come." Like that he said. See, this inequality in villages as well as in cities, it is there. But in the rural areas, that is in village area, this caste identity is experienced at very young age itself. Because in the village area, due to the caste, conflicts are takes place. Many conflicts and violence takes place. So, from the young age, the children are experiencing the caste inequalities. But in urban area, more educated people are there. But still there also this problem is there. When we are looking at the matrimonials shown from leading English newspapers, we can see that the important issue of caste continues to be in the minds of the highly educated urban Indians. When we are seeing matrimonials, that is match fixing, male and female for the marriage. Even here also it is given, alliance invited. In that it is given caste no bar, SEST excuse. So like that it has given. And Tamil Brahmin Iyengar. So like that it will be given. So based on that we can identify that caste inequality is still there in urban areas also. Now we will go to one more story, Mr. and Mrs. Ansari. Mr. and Mrs. Ansari searching for an apartment. They had money and so paying the rent was no problem. They went to a property dealer to find a place. The dealer informed them that he knew about quite a few apartments that were available for rent. They visited the first apartment and the Ansaris liked it very much and decided to take it. However, when the landlady found out their names, she made an excuse about how she could not rent the house to someone who ate meat because the building did not have any non-vegetarian residences. Both the Ansari and the property dealer were surprised to hear this because they could smell fish being cooked in the neighbor's house. The same excuse was repeated in the second and third apartments. Finally, the property dealer told them that they might want to change their names and call themselves Mr. and Mrs. Kumar. See, Mr. and Mrs. Ansari, they are not getting an apartment. Due to their name, this is based on the religion. So, they are not getting an apartment. So, the property dealer says that they have to change their name Mr. and Mrs. Kumar. But, the Ansaris were not interested in that. So, they decided to look some more. In the end, it took a whole month of looking at apartments before they found a landlady who was willing to give them a place on rent. So at last they find one apartment, but it taken them 1 month, full 1 month. So here, Om Prakash Valmiki and Ansaris are being treated unequally on the basis of difference of caste and religion. So their dignity is get affected. Now what is dignity? This refers to thinking of oneself and other persons as worthy of respect. So dignity means ourselves we are feeling highly respectful and we have to give respect for others also. So here the dignity of both Om Prakash Valmiki and Ansari was violated because of the way in which they were treated. By picking on him and making him sweep on the school because of his caste, Om Prakash Valmiki's schoolmates and teachers hurt his dignity badly and made him feel as if he was less than equal to all other students in the school. Being a child, Om Prakash could not do anything. But his father get angry and he reacted for that. He confronted the teachers. Ansari's dignity was also hurt. Ansari's dignity also get affected. But when persons refused to leave the apartment to them, however, when the property leader suggested that they can change their name, it was their dignity or self-respect that made them refuse this suggestion. Om Prakash and the Ansari do not deserve to be treated like this. They deserve the same respect. So, they also like others, they also have to deserve the same respect. So again, I repeat, dignity means it refers to thinking of oneself and other persons as worthy of respect. So when the dignity is affected, we will react for that. So all the people will have their own dignity. So there is no differences based on the religion, caste, or economy. And in 1975, there a film came, Deewar. In this film, a boy who works as a shoe shine refuses to pick up a coin thrown at him. He feels that there is dignity in the work that he does and insists that his fees to be given respectfully. This shows that the small boy also have the dignity, have the feeling of dignity. Okay. To overcome this problem of inequality in India, what is done? Is there equality in all India? No. Before that, we will see this parliament. Parliament is the cornerstone of our democracy, and we represent in it through our elected representative. So, all our assemblies taken place there, and our constitution gives answer to this question of inequality. Our constitution written by Dr. B.R. Ambedkar. Ambedkar said, man is mortal. Everyone has to die someday or the other, but one must resolve to lay down one's life in enriching the noble ideals of self-respect and in bettering one's human life. Nothing is more disgraceful for a brave man than to live life devoid of self-respect. So Dr. B.R. Ambedkar is the father of Indian Constitution. He is the architect of Indian Constitution. He is the chairman of the drafting committee of the Indian Constitution. He is the first law and justice minister. In his small age, he was also get affected by the caste system. So, with this committee, he written the laws which is helpful for our country, for our people to overcome the problem of inequality. So, our Indian Constitution uses so many provisions to overcome the problem of the inequalities which were in India. Now, what is Constitution? Constitution is a document that lays down the basic rules and regulations for people and the government in the country to follow. Constitution is a written document. Here the rules and regulations, the laws are written for the people and the government in the country to follow. It is like if you join in a school, your school handbook, they will give some rules and regulations. You have to follow. Similarly, for a country also, rules and regulations are there. We have to follow the rules and regulations. That is written in the constitution. So, constitution is a document that lays down the basic rules and regulations. So, it will give the basic rule, fundamental rule, whichever followed, fundamental regulations and fundamental rights and duties. Basic rules and regulations for the people and the government in the country to follow. People as well as the government also has to follow. The constitution is followed by the people as well as the government. Whatever written in the constitution, people also follow, the government also follow. So the rules are very, very important. The laws written in this are very important. The first page of our Indian constitution is known as preamble. In that it's given India is a India is a democratic country. It's a secular country. And whatever given in constitution, how we can overcome the problem of inequality, how the constitution helpful for us in this matter, we will see in the next coming class, children. So in the next class, we will see what are all the provisions given by the constitution to overcome the problem of the inequality and what are all the other issues of equality in other democracies. All these things we will see in the next class. And then we will see what are the ways in which our constitution helps us. And then challenges of democracy in the next coming class. With this, I will complete today's class. Thank you, children. Thank you.